Lance, they were pulling.
Good morning, everybody. It's kind of neat that they're in person or they're on.
You won't be here next week.
Next week is.
Days.
Oh, I want to meet you.
So what's the day on Sunday?
It's Mother's Day next week, but that's where we're just.
Oh, I see. Oh, you won't be here next week.
We will be.
Okay, thank you. All right, so let's take a few minutes and find your sit bones and ground down. Just a moment at the center. I like to turn my palms up. Soften your shoulder, roll them back up and spine. Making a conscious effort to take your awareness inward rather than outward. Just noticing. Noticing the breath. Noticing the muscles and bones. Noticing the tension. Take one more easy breath in. Inhale. You're ready, Lord. Move our fingers and toes, you can gently open your eyes. Okay. Let's move to the edge of our chair. Again, mindful. All right. So inhale up to the side, just reach your nose, arms all the way up and out and down. Next time your hands come up at shoulder height, turn them up to the ceiling and then bring them together. See how that feels. And then as they come down, the shoulder height will turn them down. You're kind of following the natural tendency of your shoulder. And the last one. We'll roll those shoulders up, down, and back. And then when you get them up, down, and back, I'll squeeze the shoulder blades a bit. And then release the effort. And we'll make some more circles towards the back. And circles towards the front. It's take a little more effort for me. And then we'll bring the shoulders to center and then draw them up to your ears. And release. Really bring them down. Lots of space between your ears and your shoulder. Again, we'll bring them up. And then really bring them down. And one last time, up to your ears. And release. Stick the arms out in front, press through the heels of your hands, lots of space between your fingers, and then draw your fingers down, and then again back to the feet. Do a nice stretch in the wrist. Again, we'll press through the heel of your hands, lots of space, and then fingers go down, and then back to the feet. And the reach, we'll give them a little shake. We'll bring them together and interlace your fingers and press forward and then all the way up as you can. Just kind of move off to one side. You don't stay with very long. Just beginning to open. There's a reach to your sit bones. And one side to the other. Come to center, release the fingers. And the arms come crawling down, roll the shoulder. Let's do a twist. I'm going to move to the side of my chair just to change it up. I feel like I'm going to do the same twist a lot. So I'm sitting on the side of my chair. And I'm going to rotate my torso to reach to the back of the chair. I'm holding a 10 and 2, and then my shoulders are down. Notice how when you fill your chest with breath, it kind of opens a little bit. And then when you exhale, you might have a little more space to come into a deeper twist. So use your breath that way. And then we'll release the chair and come to the side. Let's go to the other side. Just find your sit bones. One feels a little deeper than the other. And we'll twist the torso and hold on to the back of your chair, 10 to 2. And take a moment to use your breath here as you fill up the belly and your torso with breath. Kind of opens you, and then when you allow the breath to leave, you might be able to come a little deeper into your chair. Next time you inhale, we'll release the back of your chair and come forward again. A nice tall spine. Let's bring the arms out to the side again and up. And then as you exhale, we'll bring the arms down. We'll bring them to the top of our thighs and then ease down towards your ankles. You'll inhale halfway up and down again. Using the arms to help you come up, press your feet into the mat and you'll come all the way up. Reach and look at your thumbs if your neck feels okay this morning and then we'll extend that. Vinyasa for the chair. Trying to get there. This time we'll go straight up with our fingers, straight up. Exhale out to the side and down. You can use the same breath, elongate that exhale down. Inhaling halfway up and exhaling all the way down. Press your feet into the floor, help yourself. Come all the way up, look at your thumbs. It's okay with your neck. And you'll exhale down. And one last time, we're going straight up. And exhale out and down. So you can hold the same breath all the way through. Using the inhale halfway up. And then exhale all the way down. Press your feet in and we'll come all the way up. And then exhale down to center. Namaste. We begin for now. I'm going to talk to you a little bit here. Fingertips to forehead and namaste. Okay, we'll keep the vinyasa going here. This time you start with your arms outside, inhaling out and up. Exhaling all the way down. This time we'll inhale and lift from the right hand up. If you're lifting out of here, that's fine too. You're lifting almost all the way up, that's fine too. Try not to lose this nice, stable base here. And then we'll exhale that arm around. Feel the twist. Inhale, left hand up. Do the best you can.
And exhale it down. Push your feet in and move it
out.
And then muscle.
So two more like that. So I'm going to go and out to the side and all the way. Use that same exhale out and all the way down.
Inhaling halfway up with your chest. Exhaling all the way down. Let's look like that right arm. Do the best you can. Keep your chin in line with your chest. It's going to bother you in the neck. Left side, inhale it up. And exhale it down. Use the inhale to reach out and up. And exhale, I want to say. Okay, let's do that there. Let's move into our hips a bit, and we'll walk the feet in line. So sitting up here, sit straight and tall. I'm trying not to use the word straight. I'm trying to lead it from my practice and think more of a tall spine rather than a straight spine, right? Okay, so we'll walk the feet together. And then we'll walk in line. And we'll leave them wide. Come down onto your forearms and my right thigh, right forearm. Arm is facing up. And I'm going to inhale up. Left arm, I'm going to fix my ear. And then exhale down into the center. Nice tall spine. Other side. Left forearm crosses. Left thigh. Inhale up. Right on, right up next to my ear, open your chest. Inhale, exhale, and come back to center. Start the feet together. And we'll extend the right leg. Be mindful here, this is a walking chair. We'll add a reach all the way down to the ankle. And then inhale it up. Other side, stretch out that left foot and out of reach. Inhale back and up. So back to the first side, right leg, stretch it out and out of reach. And inhale back and up. And last one, left side. Back seated. Set yourself up with a nice tall spine. And then walk the feet wide. Ankles underneath. Sometimes our feet are more forward or back. You can get directly under there and we'll sit up with a nice tall spine. Let's try a goddess pose in this position. So we're going to use the arms out to the side, and then bend at the elbows, so it looks like this. On an in-breath, we'll reach, and an exhale, we'll bring the elbows in, and squeeze those shoulder blades in the back. Breathe. Using the inhale to reach and stretch. Exhale down to the chest. Reach and stretch. Exhale. Push your feet into the floor. Keep the bottom of your body active. Last one. And release your arms and we'll walk the feet together. And take your right knee to go over one. And left knee to go over one. And we'll do some open pose. And coming to center, I think we're good to stand up. We'll come. I'm going to put my chair at the top of my mat. stand to the side here. You just come up onto the ball with your feet. You can spend any time around your feet. You don't have to be going up on the ball with your feet. When you're clicking, talking. And then lift your toes, lots of space between them. It's a challenging today. Feels like a lot of work.
It's getting soft, so go back instead of going to stay there.
Yeah, you know. Well, you can go on to the floor.
I'm trying to test
myself. Okay, just one more. And then we'll roll to the other side and the inside. You might have to open your feet a little wider to go to the inside. And then come to the center. Okay, let's turn to face the back of the chair and we'll just gently walk back into the downward dog. Easy to leave your arm. And then use the inhale to come back to mountain. And a couple more times, we'll use the exhale to come back to downward dog. Use the knees. Use the inhale to walk back into mountain. And one last time, use the exhale to walk back into downward dog. We'll come to the side. This is my left side. In the chair, it doesn't matter. We're going to go. And we're going to open up and be nice and wide. So the foot that's closest to the chair, we're going to use my left foot. I'm going to turn the toes to face underneath the chin. And then this is my right foot. Outside here, I'm going to bring it halfway in. Almost towards the chin. And then the torso stays facing for me to swallow. And for you to swallow. So once you get those feet placed, press your feet in, nice strong legs. Engage your thighs. We're going to inhale up the arms, shoulder height. And as you exhale, bend the forward knee, the one closest to the chair. Beautiful. And if you feel like you can, turn the head and look over that outstretched arm. Beautiful. Really engage these legs, especially your bottom on the right side. Really engage it, use it, tighten it up. Let's inhale to straight legs and exhale. And do it again one more time. Inhale enough. Exhale, bend the forward knee. See if you can look over that outstretched arm. Engage the legs. Inhale, straighten the legs and exhale. Let's do one more. Inhaling arms up and exhaling forward knee bends. Warrior, this is warrior two. This is proud warrior. And warriors are very heat building, strength building, heat producing. We'll inhale, straighten the legs and exhale. Put your toes forward. And then we'll walk them together. Let's take a breath in between before we go to the other side. For you, you can just turn around and face the opposite direction. I'm going to switch my chair so I'm going to go forward. So beginning the mountain and opening up the feet nice and wide. So I start with the toes kind of looking at the corners of the room. And this is my right foot
closest to the chair, and then pivot on the heel and hopefully close the left knee. And then my left foot, I'm going to bring halfway in. Like the body possibilities today, but we're going to sit forward. So we'll be on some knee issues. So this particular position may torque. You might feel a little torque, but you don't want that. So what you need to do to make yourself comfortable, if you need to move your feet, you'll use the inhale to lift the arms. Exhale and bend forward knee. I'm just close to my chair. And then if you feel like you can, you can go over that other stretch. Inhale, straighten the legs, exhale the arms down. Try it again, inhale. Arms up, shoulder height, exhale, bend forward. Engage right legs. Inhale, straighten the legs, and exhale the arms down. Last one. Exhale, bend forward, knee. And straighten those legs, the arms come down. Toes are pointing forward, and we'll lock the feet together. It's time for a breath. Yeah, it's a good rest. I never noticed that before.
Oh, it's perfect.
Yeah, it's great.
The other thing with this background, I do it also sometimes, my spouse is stretched.
Oh, right.
Because it's not good on the floor.
Right, right. Yeah, I get that.
I've took it both ways.
Is it a yoga mat?
Yeah.
Alright, I'm going to switch the chair, but for you, you just have to turn around. So, this is my left side. It doesn't matter, I'm going to get control. And again, we're going to open those feet wide. We're not going to go too wide. Chair here if you need it. We're going to inhale up into my right arm, right next to my ear. And then with the left hand, you can place it on the top of the chair. And then we're just going to open up the whole right side. You can stay in the same plane rather than coming forward, but just it's about opening that side. And you might not even need the chair if you have anything. We'll inhale it up. Inhaling out to the side, all the way up next to your ear. Exhale down. I'm getting on my chair. Engage the legs. Inhale it up. Exhale down. And that side, out to the side and all the way up. Exhale. Open that whole right side. And use the inhale to come up and exhale the arm. Walk the feet together and we'll hold for a breath and then. For you, you can just turn around. For me, I'm going to just make sure. Inhale, and then the toes under the chair and point under the chair. The toes. Outside, I'm going to come halfway. Actually, I didn't do that last time. Toes forward. I'm still in warrior mode. It's okay. This time, the left arm right over next to your ear, and exhale, open the whole left side. Inhale to come up, and exhale the arm down. Use the inhale to bring the arm up. And exhale, open the whole left side. Inhale up and exhale down. Last one. And exhale, bring down. Let's walk the feet together. A good time now is in the downward dog. I'm standing behind my chair, and I'm going to ease back, walking back into the downward dog.
when you're looking bilaterally on each side, it's good to come to center. And the power dog's a good way to do that.
Your knees up.
Okay, let's come back to our decision. Not quite the edge, almost like halfway. Well, I guess I'm a little bit halfway. Okay, sitting up in the soft spine. We're going to use our exhale to reach down towards your ankles and just let your campaign. Go down there. See if you can shake your head a little bit on up and down. Yes. I'm going to release the effort and a little twist to each side now. And you'll come to center and just walk those hands up and over. Release your breath in. Let's do it again. I look at you through the ragdoll, which is more of a standing posture, but it's using your breath and kind of letting everything go all the way down. So start with the breath in. Just bring your torso forward, right on top of your thighs, let everything come down and forward. And hang your head, hang your arms. Make contact with your hands to something, whether it's the floor or your feet or your shins. And then press your feet in and you'll walk up and back. Head is the last way you come up. Notice how when you come forward, for me, my knees widen a little bit. So let's see if you can keep that base nice and strong with ankles under your knees. And we'll use the breath to come forward again. Use the exhale to come forward again. So see if you can keep those legs and ankles and feet nice and stable and strong and let your head move. Next time you feel the breath and walk, the hands up and back. Let's loosen everything up. Okay. Let's come to the end of our chair. I'm going to do a downward dog. It would be like a half downward dog. I'm going to stretch one leg forward. Just don't trust the stretch two. Typically, we'll do both. We're going to do one side and then the other. This is my right leg stretching out, pressing through the heel. Nice tall spine. I'm going to take my arms up to the side. And then all the way up with your palms facing forward here. Really plant this leg and split into your mat. And we're going to exhale and come forward. Not a lot forward. To get forward. You can keep your head between your upper arms and we'll inhale it up. And the arms come out. Keep on the floor, go to the other side of your mind. Left leg stretching forward, activating. Getting a nice tall spine. Your right foot and leg is really pressing in there. We'll use our breath to take the arms out and up. The metaphysics are here again. We're just coming just a bit forward. That's it. And then inhaling yourself back. And the arms come out and down on the floor. Let's take your right knee to your chest. And we'll give a little squeeze. And your right knee to your chest. A little bit of sleep. and feet on the floor. Okay, so I'm going to sit back in my chair. And I'm going to go halfway down in my chair. And then start with my self-spine. So we're going to use the tree pose, so I want to be mindful of what you're feeling in your hip. I'm going to lift my right foot, just take the ankle onto my left thigh. If it feels like too much, you have the option of just kind of opening up your hip by coming to the side of your foot. Or if you had blocks, you come up onto the blocks. Okay. So ankle on thigh. Moment to really make sure the standing foot is nice and stable, ankle underneath. And we'll sit up nice and tall. We'll take our hands together into namaste. Pull your belly in nice and tight, and we're going to inhale. And lift those arms right up and over your head. And then exhale down to center. And then we'll release the leg. And then we'll give a little squeeze. And then other side, give a nice soft spine. Taking left ankle now onto right thigh. And make sure your ankle is directly under your knee here. Mindful of your hip. Maybe this doesn't feel good, maybe this doesn't work for you. And that's okay. Bring our hands into namaste. Inhale right up and over. Into tree pose. Exhaling down. Center of your chest and over the knees, back ankle. And then give a little squeeze. Coming to the edge of your chair, we'll walk those feet together, squeeze your ankles, squeeze your knees and thighs, and then we're just going to come to the side of your right foot and see if you can let that right hip open up. So this one doesn't move. This hip and this leg and this foot are grounded down. And right side is open, right up on the side of my right foot here. Okay, this tall spine. We're going to take the arms down by your side. This is called an eagle pose. We're going to inhale your wings up to the side and then the elbows. And then they come together in front of your chest. So elbows. Heels of your hands and fingers. You can keep it right here. And breathe. If you want to take it a little bit further, you can scoop my right arm under, and those fingers reach towards your palm. You can also do hands back to back. So find something that doesn't feel overwhelming, but you feel like you're getting a nice stretch in your shoulder blades. And then we'll draw elbows together, heels of your hands and fingers. And we'll take our feet go into plank just a couple of times. Inhaling open and exhaling. And then drop the elbows, drop the arms, shake. No pose. This is standing pose typically. Feet together, ankles together, knees together, and then we're going to come up onto the side of my left foot here. Now it's very easy to let both of the knees fall away, but you're really going to be ground down. And your foot and your leg is stable, it's not falling on the side of your left foot. Just the hip is holding to the side. Just letting that happen. And soft spine, arms by our side, we'll inhale along the coat and up. Bend those elbows and then bring them together in front. And let's stretch behind your shoulders. If you want to take it a little further, this time the left arm. Just under, and it's like a little twist here. The
feel like kind of twisting of the shoulders. Or you go back to our elbows, use your hands and fingers, and take flight into your in breath. And exhale. Again. Inhale and then exhale. Drop those elbows, knees together, and feet on the floor. Let's take the breath. And your left knee to the chest a little smoothly. And the chair. Walk those feet. Hip width apart. We're going to use a breath to come forward. Use your exhale to come forward. And reach all the way down. Let's do a half triangle, I guess. We're going to inhale up right arm. And exhale it down. Inhale up, left arm, and reach, and exhale it down. Press your feet into the floor, and inhale, both arms up, and exhale, namaste. Okay. And your chair, we're gonna lock those feet on the side. Come down onto our elbows and we'll come to the center. So elbow on my left side, elbow on my right, and just kind of hanging out. See if you can bring those ankles under your knees in good lines. In straight lines. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna inhale and lift the heart. Exhale, round your spine, pull your belly in. Inhale and lift your heart, beautiful. And exhale and round. Just go back and forth in your breath. And exhale. Do it one more time. And then ease yourself back to center. We're going to take turns doing a little twist to your shoulders. Beginning with your right shoulder, we're going to dip it down. And your head and your neck. Your safe bet is to keep your chin in line with your chest. But if you want to look in the opposite direction, it's a little bit of a stretch for your neck too. So we'll inhale to center and exhale. Left shoulder comes between. You're looking in the opposite direction. Keep your shoulders down away from your ears. I'm dipping right shoulder and then left. Looking right and looking left. Do it one more on your side, right? And we'll place the heels of the hands where the elbows were and we're walking together. Bring that nice and tall. Walk those feet together. So this is goddess pose. We actually use this for our warm up. If you can come up onto the ball of your feet, see how that feels. You might not like it. You might prefer to get your feet flat. Just give it a try. The balls of your feet under your knees, nice tall spine. We'll begin with the arms down by our side and we'll bring them up and out. And then bend them. Use the exhale to bring the elbows towards chest and squeeze the shoulder blades. It looks like
And then exhale and squeeze. Beautiful. Two more times. Inhale. And reach and exhale and squeeze. And last one. Now as you squeeze, you can get every last bit of air out. And then release the effort. And heat down the floor. It's a little open, close, open, close. And then we'll stretch one leg and add a reach. And release the back on the other side and add a reach. And release on the back. Let's sit back in our chair and support your own spine. So it's tempting to settle back in the chair, but support your own spine so that your feet are nice and flat on the floor. My feet don't go all the way to the floor here, and I'm tall. Okay, so here we are. So we're going to do a little stretch to the eyes, stretch to the face, stretch to the eyes. So the lioness pose looks like this. You bring your hands onto your thighs. And it begins with a nice deep breath. And then as you exhale, you open your eyes nice and wide. Like it's big, you can make them really wide. And then we're going to open our mouth. Start again with a nice deep breath. So now the eyes are open and the mouth is open wide. That's it. Last time. This time your eyes are wide, your mouth is open, and your tongue is sticking out. And it begins with a nice deep breath. Inhale and up and back. That ha sound, that ha. You'll believe that it rids your body of toxin. Get all the bad stuff out. So I work with a man that is on the spectrum. And I tell him, get it out, get all the bad stuff out. And it works for him. So he uses it. Just kind of nice deep breath in. My goodness. It's so fun. It's so perfect. I'm sure that's you can see all the filling in. Okay. So for the eyes, we've done this before. So I would imagine this big clock, like it's as big as the room, right? 12 is as far as you can look up. 6 is as far as you can look down. 9 is as far as you can look to each side. So we'll sit with a nice tall spine. And we'll just look from up and down. We'll start with up and down. So looking all the way up, as high as we look up. And then gently look all the way down. So this is like looking under your chin. And then we'll go back to looking up, all the way up. And then looking down, all the way down. As far as you can see. See if you can open up that edge a bit. One last time, all the way up. And then all the way down. And close your eyes and create some heat with your hands by rubbing them together. Think of really allowing the eyes just to be heavy. And then we'll cup the time with your hands. And the idea is that the warmth that you've created will ease any stress in the upper muscles. And then release the heat. So how often do we stretch our eyes? Not very often.
Actually, you should do that when I was 12, 13, 14.
Oh, wow.
That's how I get my turn on.
Okay.
So,
and it's all muscular. So my daughter had the same thing. Her eye would kind of wobble a little bit, and as she grew older, it went away. So let's do side to side now. So as far as we look to the left or right, it doesn't matter which way. So you see, you can really stretch the edge. So you're really stretching the edge. And then to the other side. And then back to the first side. Stretch, stretch. What's looking behind your head? And then to the opposite side. And one last one, back to the first side. And let's close your eyes and breathe that heat. And then we'll cup our eyes and really think about allowing the eyes to settle. And then release your hands. And now we will engage our big clock. So we'll do some clockwise and counterclockwise. So we'll begin at 12. So you'll look at 12 is as far as you're going to look for the ceiling. It's something you look for. You can just look with your eyes all the way up. And then we'll move it over to the 1, wherever the 1 be. And then the 2, wherever the 2 be. And then the 3 all the way over to the edge. And then we're dropping down to 4. And then 5. And then all the way down to 6. 5 as you can see. Down. And we're starting to come up on the other side. 7. And then 8. As we're coming up. 9. I guess halfway there. And 10. And 11, and then all the way up to 12 again. Close your eyes, breathe and eat. And we'll cut the eyelids, letting them fall back into the socket and stretch them. And we'll do one last one counterclockwise. So we'll begin by looking up at the 12. And remember, it's as far as you can look up, like looking above your head. And this time we're going counterclockwise. So we're moving towards the 11. And then the 10. And then 9. And then down to the 8. And 7. And all the way down under your chin for the 6. And then climbing up. And 5. And 4. All the way over to 3. And 2. And 1. And back. All the way up to level 12, and close your eyes and create the heat. And then cut your eyes. And then release the effort. Let's do some blinks. My eyes definitely feel like
stretch.
Yeah. For people with balance issues, they say you should stretch your eyes. You want to exercise your bum, and you bring it all. Let's do it. Okay. So let's take your right thumb out, right out in front, and you're going to bring the thumb all the way over as far as you can go, and then we'll see if your eyes can follow. So you're not moving your head, just for starting to thumb. Watching it as it moves. And there's a point where you're really stretching the eye. And see how long you can see it. And then we'll bring it back. Out in front, and then we'll let go. Let's close our eyes and we'll create the heat again. Just a little for you. And see if breath in. Release the eyes. So this is my left arm and thumb. And I'm just really kind of getting it again for the thumbnail. That's my focus. I'm going to ease it over to the left. Let's see if we can get it focused. And at some point, you see it, but it's not really focused anymore, right? It's out there, but you can't really focus on it. I can't anyway, I should see. And then we'll ease it back. Start to notice when it comes into focus. And then close your eyes and create that heat. And then cup your eyes and go in. And then when you're ready, release the effort. Blanking is good. Rehydrates. And then a stretch for the face. So not really a stretch, I guess, but some attention for your jaw. So take your thumbs and place them right in that little pocket in your ear. And it's like a little pocket under there. And you drag them forward until they come to a little cavern where your jaw hangs together. You'll know it when you get there, because most people hold a lot of tension. And when you get there, just do a little circular massage in one direction and then the other. If you're a tooth grinder, if you're a tooth grinder, and then release the effort, we'll open the mouth a few times. See how it works. My jaw makes noise. Let's try it again. So thumb under the pockets of your ears and then you drag them forward and then you kind of find this indentation.
It's 9:53, Sharon.
Okay. When you press, you feel that kind of tenderness. At least I do, as you've seen. And then release it and close. Let's try another alignment. Here we go. Just hold it up that way. Hands on thighs. Open eyes. Open mouth. See you again. Coming back to center. Look at this with your dominant hands. This is my right hand. What you're going to do is you're going to roll your knuckles onto your eyebrows. So start at the kind of base of the eyebrow. And you just go a little back and forth. And then when you get there and you find a place that might be a little tender, you can draw a little circle. And then go in the opposite direction. The other side, a little fist with your hand. A
and start the base of your eyebrow. And just back and forth and draw the shape of your eyebrow. And you find a place that feels a little tender. You can make some circles. And you press the knuckles in and it feels okay. Back to the opposite hand, so your dominant hand. You're going to do the same thing along your hair line. Just kind of back and forth. And then when you find a place that is tender, you're going to move your circle. Other hand, super circulation tends to be a place where we hold a lot of tension. We still have this really great book, Yoga for the Face, but I don't have it anymore. And then release the effort, we're not aligning this pose, even though it's important. But, one more time. Deep breath, let it out. All right, let's settle back in our chair. This time, if your spine might be tall, but then ease back into your chair. Let your spine and your torso feel supported. Turn your palms, turn our palms down. And start to notice your breath. So begin with the head and adjust. Notice the muscles in your shoulders and your neck. Hold your head. See if you can breathe into that space and just let a bit of that tension go. Allowing that relaxation to kind of flow down to the shoulders. And softening your upper arms and your forearms and your hands. As you breathe the breath into the chest, see if you can ease out any stress or tightness that you're holding there. Moving that effort down to your belly. So you can allow it to be big and soft. And working down into your thighs and shins and melting the in your toes, and your feet and heels and ankles. And filling your body with breath, reaching all those small spaces that are hard to get to. And as the breath moves out, you just settle it down. Seems to move in the finger and the toes. And when you're ready, open your eyes and open your eyes. I'm breathing down. And everything clear. Send our hands in front of our heart. We're bringing them way up here to your forehead, making that mind life and make sure it's above and on us. Know your side. I feel good. I'm not doing that. All right.